JRA-501. Yinghuo-1 is a Chinese Mars exploration space probe. It is attached along with the Russian Phobos-Grunt sample return spacecraft, which is intended to visit Mars moon Phobos. The Yinghuo-1 probe will orbit Mars for around 2 years, studying the planet's surface, atmosphere, ionosphere, and magnetic field. Was, past tense. Okay. So the Yinghuo's primary scientific objectives are to conduct detailed investigation of plasma and magnetic field of Mars, the Martian ion escape process and their possible mechanisms, observe sandstorms on the Martian surface, and the probe's scientific payload consists of four primary instrument packages. A plasma package consisting of an electron analyzer, ion analyzer, and a mass spectrometer, a flux gate magnetometer, a radio occultation sounder, and an optical imaging system consisting of two cameras, allowing high-quality images of the Martian surface to be captured from orbit. Although Phobos-Grunt's primary objective is to obtain surface samples from the Martian moon Phobos, Yinghuo-1 experienced periods up to 8.8 hours in darkness when it orbited, carries it over Mars' night side. So let's learn a little bit about that. On board is the Life Experiment shuttle and Phobos. Why are we trying to fly microorganisms to Phobos and back? To test whether organisms can survive 4 years in deep space. We want to fly selected organisms in a simulated meteoroid, a small canister, aboard the Russian Phobos sample return mission over a 3-year deal. LIFE, Living Interplanetary Flight Experiment, will test one aspect of transpermia, the hypothesis that life could survive space travel if protected inside rocks blasted by impact off one planet to land on another. For example, could they make it from Mars to Earth? Organisms have never been tested to see if they could survive beyond the protection of Earth's magnetosphere for multi-year periods. Couldn't you just do this on an Earth-orbiting spacecraft? No. Earth's magnetosphere, the area of influence of its magnetic field, protects near-Earth spacecraft from the charged particle component of galactic cosmic radiation, and solar particle events. Speaking of solar events, we've had X-class solar flares almost every day. For how long now? Just wondering if that might have had something to do with the fail of Phobos-Grunt. Has this type of experiment ever been done before? Yes, aboard Apollo. What are the other current design constraints? The BIOMODULE has 30 small tubes for individual microbe samples. It also accommodates a native sample of bacteria derived from a desert region on Earth with a cavity of 26 millimeters in diameter. The BIOMODULE must be sealed to meet experimental validation requirements and to provide additional planetary protection. The requirement was that the module must be able to withstand a single 4,000 G impact, as would occur with a hard landing on Earth. The sample return capsule has no parachute. Without the seals failing or the outer case fracturing, also desired were simple means of recording radiation doses and temperature extremes during its flight and return to Earth. So I'd like to know why we are taking native samples of bacteria from Earth. Now, I did read somewhere exactly where this was, and I can't remember now. And I can't find it. But I thought this was really interesting. Bacteria from Earth. I think it was something like the Sudan or some place in that area. And I also thought it was interesting that a lot of scientific research has been done to prove that life originated where? North Africa? So anyway, I had some red flags about this. Just my deal. Do they want to propagate life on Mars? And that's what this is really all about. Here is the biomodule. We are flying representatives of three domains of life: bacteria, eukaryota, and archaea. Are any of the microbes being flown dangerous to humans? No, none of the microbe strains being selected will be dangerous. Could these microbes mutate in space and return as dangerous microbes? Dangerous mutation is extremely improbable because we are sending only desiccated, inactive microbes without sources of nutrition and energy, and they will not be reproducing. To create evolutionary successful mutations, an organism needs to reproduce. The development of evolutionary successful mutations, good or bad, requires conditions favorable to microbial growth. In order to give the microbes maximum chance of surviving the trip, the life experiment requires that the microbes travel in desiccated, inactive, non-replicating state, the exact opposite of what is needed to change a microbe gene pool in any meaningful way. All our organisms will be non-pathogenic, do not cause disease. To change these benign organisms without the forcers of natural evolution and by random chance to generate dangerous and viable organisms is incredibly improbable. Even with the very low probabilities, we will take great care with the samples and follow standard biological protocols to always err on the side of extreme caution. And as in all aspects of the experiment, we will get external review of our analysis and plans. So there is not a 100%. There is not a 100%. If they're saying low probabilities, they've never done this before. How can they say that these things might not contaminate Mars and other planets, Mars moons? How can they say that whatever is there would be able to turn it into any of this stuff into monsters? Is it likely that this experiment could contaminate Mars with life, thus confusing future searches for life on Mars? The short answer is that is extremely unlikely. Again, unlikely, low possibilities. To me, that's not good enough. But I guess when you're trying to conquer the universe, you'll take those risks. We emphasize this is a mission to Mars Moon Phobos, not to the surface of Mars. But yet they're saying they're trying to figure out if things, pieces, chunks of Phobos or rocks that are hurled through space survive, you know, these, what am I trying to say? The microbes stay inside the rocks, and that's where they're preserved. So I'm not understanding how they can say that this is unlikely. If there's a rock that comes off of Mars, if we put something on Phobos, who's to say that it wouldn't go to Mars? Phobos Life fully complies with the COSPAR Committee on Space Research of the International Council for Science, which, by the way, there are many people that are saying, no, they don't. No, they don't comply. And there's many people that are totally against what they're doing here, what they were trying to do. Okay? So, okay, so a little bit more about this. Three fundamental guidelines governed by the selection of the organisms. First, the organisms selected represent the three domains of life. And then here we have the organisms listed below. Okay, here's the criticism. Barry E. D. Gregorio, the director of the International Committee Against Mars Sample Return, criticized the life experiment on the Phobos-Grunt mission as a violation of the Outer Space Treaty of 1967 due to its risk of contaminating Phobos or Mars with microbial spores and live bacteria it contains, the live bacteria that came from Earth. While the mission lands and returns from Phobos, a moon of Mars, the risk of Mars itself is from the possibility of Phobos-Grunt losing control and crash landing on the planet. It is speculated that the heat-resistant extremophile bacteria would be particularly able to survive such a crash on the basis that heat-resistant bacteria, Microbispora, survived the Space Shuttle Columbia disaster. Okay. So my next video, I'm going to focus in on part two, will be what these bacteria are.